Linux audio was hit or miss for many years. Whether it's Pulse Audio crackling at the worst times or jack being too complicated for casual users, getting great sound on Linux used to feel like a battle. But in recent years, one project has been quietly revolutionizing how Linux handles audio and video, and that project is, of course, PipeWire. And today, there is a new PipeWire to talk about with PipeWire 1.4. It's packed with many new features that will make Linux audio even more powerful and flexible and future-proof to a point, from MIDI 2.0 support to improved Bluetooth audio and even better compatibility with pro audio tools. This update is a very nice thing to see. So let's break it down. But first, a quick refresher. PipeWire is an open source framework designed to handle audio and video streams on Linux. It's essentially how apps and services interact with each other, replacing both Pulse Audio and Jack, giving users the best of both worlds with lower latency, better performance, and wider hardware support. It's already the default on many major Linux distributions, most major Linux distributions, and with this latest release, it's just getting better. One of the biggest highlights of PipeWire 1.4 is full support for MIDI 2.0. This means better precision, higher resolution, and more flexibility for musicians and producers. PipeWire now carries both legacy MIDI 1.0 and 2.0 through a new Universal MIDI Packet or UMP system, making it easier to integrate modern MIDI hardware and software. Bluetooth audio also gets a boost with support for BAP broadcast links, meaning better compatibility with modern Bluetooth devices. More importantly, there's now direct support for hearing aids using ASHA or ASHA, audio streaming for hearing aids. This is a huge accessibility win, which is fantastic, making Linux more inclusive for users with hearing impairments. Also, for professionals, PipeWire 1.4 introduces a new jack control API, improving compatibility with high-end audio tools and workflows. There's also better Pulse Audio integration with a new system service for PulseWire or PipeWire Pulse, making it easier to manage and configure. Also, performance improvements are everywhere. There's new RISC-V support, meaning PipeWire is now optimized for emerging open source hardware. Our WebRTC 2.0 support has been added to the echo cancel code, making it more reliable for voice calls. And also video users, an FFmpeg-based video conversion plugin brings new compatibilities for PipeWire's video adapter. PipeWire is making Linux audio better for everyone. And it's proving that Linux can compete with or even surpass other operating systems when it comes to multimedia performance. Of course, PipeWire also does video piping, not just audio. And PipeWire is so cool.